somewhat over a month ago, Robbie Burns, Paul Schimmons, and I were talking about our rooms and how they're set up. So I wanted to give you a real quick tour of my classroom. Now, this building just opened this past fall of 2018, and this was a new room, and in fact, the floor wasn't even in the day that we had open house before school started in my room. So it is still not totally complete. We're getting closer every day. For example, I now have a desk, which I didn't have until after we came back from winter break. So things are good. But students walk in through this door behind me here, and they come and they sit down in these chairs behind me over here. You can see our first row of ukuleles on the wall. We still have another row of storage system that needs to be installed. And the other ukuleles are behind me here, where students come up and get them. Now, right immediately on this kind of odd wall out to the hallway, there is a TV monitor which leads to our auditorium, a beautiful auditorium in this building. Thankfully, because of our wonderful drama program and the positive thing that it is in our community. So we do middle school musicals, and the school has had that tradition for about 15 years, and that guaranteed that we actually have a performance space. It seats about 400 students, and it's wonderful. And anyhow, this TV goes to a camera that's mounted in the auditorium and can be used for a live feed, so that this room can be used as overflow or as a green room. Now, students, when they're sitting down, they're looking this way behind me. You can see the AvantGrande, I think it's the NU1X piano, which is awesome. It has actual hammers, but it's still a digital piano, so it doesn't need to be tuned. And you can see the large monitor by Smart. I think it's 70 inches, might be 75 inches. It could be bigger in a room this size, but that is what we have. They decided not to go with any more projectors when they were building a room. We do have an Apple TV connected to it. Every room has an Apple TV, but I do so much with video that the video glitches when I'm trying to run video. Now, it doesn't do that at home, but it does do it here, and we've even had the Apple specialists out, and they can't figure out what's going on with it. So I run basically to my computer on my desk over there, which is connected to an HDMI port on the wall, which comes back to the TV. So the TV is showing what's on my computer, although I could have it running an Apple TV as well. So then from my point as a teacher, I run with two iPads. I'll try to get behind me so you can see those two. The smaller iPad is given to me by the school, and that's what the school gives me. And on that, I run Keynote. Let's see, I get down here. Keynote, and then Apple Classroom, and then I can open up classes and see what students are doing on their iPads because we are a one-to-one iPad school. Also from this viewpoint, I have my own personal iPad, and what I've been doing a lot is running Notion on one side and Foursquare on the other, and I always keep my Apple Pencil at hand. This thing has a Bluetooth connection. So in past years, I would project my audio. Oh, I didn't even talk about the audio back there. Underneath the TV is an audio system. There it is. Just a standard kind of audio system. And we use a standard theater mic pack, a Shure mic pack. I've got that over here. Here's my Shure mic pack. And everything I do is amplified. And that's very, very useful in my teaching. Our room is also humidified. Currently, I can come over here and take a look at this. The humidity in the room is at, looking at it, 44%. So I have actually stayed much healthier as well. So a combination of microphone and humidity in the room makes me a healthier teacher as well. But anyhow, so what I do is, I don't know if you know this, but if you are running Keynote on your computer and they're linked up, Keynote has this wonderful little screen where on the very, very top, I can control a Keynote. And if I push play, what I can do now is whatever I do on my iPad is now going to change behind me. So I can run warm-ups from my spot or anything that I need to do. And even these ukulele videos, I can control myself by pushing play. And let's see if I can get this one to go behind me. I always put a lead time in a video.
Let's go over some ukulele basics.
So you can hear me in the background. I also have the freedom to do annotation on a slide. If you can see that behind me, I'm drawing on the screen. I might have to get closer to the screen, but I can actually draw on the screen from where I'm sitting too, and I can make that larger. And then on my iPad, I can control the NU1X AvantGrande through Bluetooth, and I can play music straight out of my piano. And that's how I did the concert as well. So instead of having to pay for a piano player and deal with piping perhaps an accompaniment through the sound system, I did everything through the piano, and it worked great on our stage. So that's kind of the quick setup of how I do things. So yes, I do use two iPads pretty much all the time. It's part of what I do, and it's not too much overload. And in fact, if you take a look, I'm running four apps at once. So I've got over here is Apple Classroom, then I've got Keynote, which is actually running Keynote remote to my Mac. Then I've got Fourscore and then Notion. The other thing that I would want to share about in technology are these things. They're wonderful, being teaching ukulele. It's the Jawoom Smart Tuner. And these things tune automatically when you put them on an instrument and you just press the right string, it tunes it to pitch. It goes to the closest pitch. Fantastic. And I've actually instituted having to assign service times for students for behaviors or for tardiness. They come in and they tune ukuleles and they do it perfectly every time because it does all the work. They just have to provide the labor of switching around. They also didn't give us a pack of a battery pack on our Shure mic systems. So we bought Amazon rechargeable batteries. So I keep those recharged most of the time, which I'm going to go and put in right now. Those last for quite a while. And that's really the room so far. It's some of it's high tech, some of it's low tech, but it all works together and it's pretty seamless for me. My favorite part is when I'm running Notion, my sixth graders felt very, very betrayed when I stood up and started directing them while the piano was still playing. They thought something was really odd in the fact that I wasn't playing piano and the piano was still making piano noises. So that's my classroom here at my school. That's how I've been using technology and controlling things. And pretty soon this room will be actually done and everything will be the way that I need it to be. So if you have any questions about the room setup, please feel free to email me. Visit the website. You can find the information there, techinmusiced.com. Have a great day.